Dear friends, in this video lecture, I am just discussing with you about to the SEO, your article. What is it means basically? This is related to the optimization of your research paper for the search engine. So, what is search engine optimization and how to optimize your research article for the different search engines? That point basically I will discuss here in this video. Might be helpful for your research article. In general, search engine optimization helps to ensure that when you type any keywords into the search box that provide some results. So, keeping that point in mind, we have to basically organize our research article in that way when the research community or anyone search a particular word, that our research paper appear on the first page of the search engines. So this task is not so easy. So large number of search engines, but some of them, Google comes at first position, then after Bing, Yahoo, Ask.com, AOL.com, DuckDuckGo, Yandex.ru. These are some popular search engines in which basically according to the countries, people search their inquiries and the points basically which they want to search. So, keeping just only the research related things here, first I want to clear that the journals. Journals are basically of two types. One has only the print copy and second one has the both online as well as print, and third one only the online. Earlier, what was going on? There was only print copy available of the research journals and the researcher basically were submitting the research article by post, right? There was no any role of the SEO. But nowadays, when publisher basically providing you online access of the articles and journals, they create a website for a specific journal and different pages into the website basically covers different aspects in addition to the article of authors. So here we consider that one page basically is assigned to a author, and that page, you know, probably carries the title of the research paper, name of the authors, their affiliations, email ID, abstract, keywords, DOI number, references, and some other metadata like that, when this paper was submitted, a volume, issue, like that. But that is not important, right? Only the title and abstract along with the keywords. So one web page basically is assigned to you, or you can say to your research article. Now when everyone is searching by using the different search engines, so obvious that a research scholar will search a particular keyword that might be associated with your research paper, and as a result, when the person is searching anything related to your article and your paper appears there, but if suppose your article doesn't appear in the search, then what is the use of that research article on that website? So there are two things. One is where author is responsible, and second is their publisher is responsible. If digital marketing team of the publisher is not efficient, obvious your research article will not circulate into the community, scientific community. And second thing, that is basically organic search, where one researcher or the person searching some thing related to your research area, and you probably optimize your research paper according to the search engine, and your paper is appearing there. And the worst case is when research paper is not optimized and your article is not basically available on the front pages of the different search engines. Actually, there are two things. One is the keywords and second is the backlinks. Backlinks works for the website and the keywords works for the pages. Pages, now you have got an idea about the pages of the website. So whatever you are writing in your research article, their keywords basically matters. So what type of keywords you are using? They are relevant to your research or research area, or they really providing some kind of scholarly feedback when the person is searching to them. So one thing is very important, that effective use of the keywords in the title and abstract. But I am aware here when I am sharing this information with you all, that traditional researcher don't know about it, and it is very difficult to them to learn about the search engine optimization. So you can get an idea. Nowadays, writing a research paper is not only the scientific skill, it is also a technical skill according to the digital marketing. So, and every publisher gives these kind of suggestions in instructions to the authors. So they says, they write huge keywords in the title and abstract, but they don't provide exact information that which keywords you have to use and how many times you have to use this keyword in the title and in abstract. That means the density of the keywords and about to the volume of the keywords. When I am using this volume word, my means to say here that how many times that keyword is searched per month, and what is the rate and what is the quality of the keyword. The volume is high or the volume is low basically matters. When Google decide the CPC, click per charges, I will discuss it in the next segment. But here my purpose was that you use keywords in the title and abstract, and whenever you use any figure, images, graphs and tables, use those keywords in the caption, and if possible write heading and subheading with the keywords into the different sections of your article. Suppose in introduction you can create, you can include any subheadings. In the methodology you can include, in the result and analysis you can include, right? So actually you have to see it where the right place to write that subheadings, and in subheadings you have to use keywords. So how to search keywords? So there are two important questions here which I think that you probably should know about to it. But because already 10 to 11 minutes I have spent here just to give a brief introduction about to the search engine optimization of the research article, so it will be very difficult for me to carry all that information here right now. But there will be two questions in the next video which I will cover, that how to search effective keywords and which keywords we have to use and how many times. Actually, density of the keywords in the title and into the abstract. So I will discuss a very simple case that is about to the keywords everywhere, which is the Chrome extension, right? And with the help, I will show you that how basically you can judge the keywords, right? So thanks for watching this video and keep in touch, and I will discuss it in the next video.